So now we are moving towards, we are going to start case study question number 32. And this case study question is based on periodic table. Okay. In his periodic table, Mendeleev arranged all the then known 63 elements, purane mein jab usko, unko 63 elements, in the order of increasing atomic masses in horizontal rows. But in such a way that the elements having similar properties came directly under one another is in the same vertical column. In the classification of the then known elements, Mendeleev was guided mainly by two factors. In order to make sure that the elements having similar properties fell in the same vertical column, Mendeleev left some gaps in his periodic table. See these gaps here. This is the old one, okay, purana one. Though the leaving of gaps in the periodic table was considered to be a big drawback of his classification of elements at that time, but Mendeleev stuck to his decision. Now, based on this, some questions are there. What are the horizontal rows of Mendeleev's periodic table known as? Periods, groups, metals, non-metals. हॉरिजेंटल रो, ये वाला हॉरिजेंटल, हॉरिजेंटल की बात कर रहा है. इट इज नोन एज पीरियड्स. ओके, एंड हाउ मेनी हॉरिजेंटल रोस ऑफ एलिमेंट्स वेर देयर इन मेंडेलीव्स ओरिजिनल पीरियोडिक टेबल, द ओल्ड वन. यू कैन काउंट द नंबर ऑफ रोस, हॉरिजेंटल रोस. Seven. The correct answer is seven. How many vertical rows were there, vertical columns? Okay. Oh, this is vertical columns were there in Mendeleev's original periodic table. 6, 7, 8, 9. The correct answer is 8. Next, the three elements having chemical symbols of silicon, boron, and germanium are dash all metals, all non-metals, all metalloids. Silicon is metalloid, B is metal, and germanium is non-metal. So which is the correct one? All are metalloids. Now the last question, according to Mendeleev's periodic law, the elements were arranged in the periodic table in the order of, this is given in the context, decreasing atomic number, increasing atomic number, decreasing atomic masses, increasing atomic masses. Which one is the correct one? Increasing atomic masses. Right. Very good. So this is the last question of this case study question. Now we'll see the next case study question in the next one. Okay. So thank you.